Welcome back. In the previous few lectures on frequency domain analysis, we have seen graphical representation of frequency response function using polar plot, and then we have seen its application in Nyquist stability analysis to analyze the closed loop stability of a system from its open loop transfer function. From today onwards, we will see another way of graphical representation called as Bode plot, and also its use for the stability analysis. So let us start with it. Bode plot is a graphical representation of frequency response . It comprises of two plots on the same graph paper or same paper. So it is unlike to like polar plot. It has two graphs or two plots on the same paper. In polar plot, the graph was a polar representation of the frequency response function, that is r theta, magnitude phase representation, combined representation. In Bode plot, the two plots, that is magnitude plot, wherein magnitude in dB versus frequency and phase plot, that is phase in degree versus frequency, are plotted on the same graph. So the graph paper used here is a semi-log paper, because in magnitude plot gain in dB or magnitude in dB is plotted versus frequency on log scale. So frequency is on the logarithmic scale, or if you use the normal graph, then it is a graph magnitude in dB versus log omega. But the graph paper used is a semi-log paper, and in phase plot, phase in degree is plotted versus frequency on log scale. So this is possible if we plot it on semi-log paper. Now, what is semi-log paper? Let us see. This one is a semi-log paper. If you look at the x-axis, it has a logarithmic scale. So this is 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, again 1. So this is one decade, and because of that, it is useful to plot it in decades. Like, for example, this axis is frequency axis. This one we use for the magnitude plot, this will be for the phase plot. Here let this be a line of minus 180 degree, and this is a line of 0 dB. Here you will have the magnitude in dB on this axis, and here phase in degrees on this axis. So let this be the frequency point 1. The drawback is that we cannot start with 0, because log 0 does not exist. So we can start with any decade. Then if this is 0.1, this will be 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9 and 1. Same way this will be 10, this will be 100, this will be 1000 and so on. So this is useful because in many cases the frequency response of a system is a low pass response, and most of the useful information is gathered at the lower frequency range. So here for every decade equal space is provided. Otherwise, if we plot it on a normal graph, then if 1000 is here, then entire data will be compressed in a very small space. Say useful data is in the range 0 to 10, it will be in a very small space, and then the remaining portion of the graph will be useless, or it is not in use, and that is why semi-log paper is used. Another case, why to plot this in dB, this magnitude? dB is a bigger scale. So if say for example gain is 1000 initially and it is falling to say 0.4, and if you get this from 0 to 1000 on a graph, then it will be a very compressed version. So if you take it in dB, then 1000 means 60 dB, 100 means 40 dB, 10 means 20 dB, 1 means 0 dB. So for every decade of the gain, there will be a one decade of the dB, one scale of the dB, and this kind of representation can be useful in representing or using the space optimally to represent the useful data. That is why the semi-log paper is used. This portion is used for magnitude plot, and this portion is used for the phase plot. Later on we will see how to plot this graph and also how to determine the stability from the Bode plot. That we will see in the latter part, but now let us see what is its use. So let us see some applications of Bode plot. So the first application is Bode plot gives the graphical representation of frequency response. So how exactly the system behaves for various frequencies, that information can be obtained from the Bode plot. The second and very important application with reference to control system is investigation of stability. Bode plot gives us the stability analysis in closed loop from the open loop transfer function of the system. Then the third useful application is in controller and compensator design. Certain information from the system's Bode plot is useful in designing the PID controllers and the lead and lag compensators. And fourth information is from the transfer function, can be obtained from the Bode plot. So if Bode plot is given, then we can retrieve back the transfer function. How that we will see. So these are the applications of Bode plot. Now let us see how the Bode plot, actual Bode plot is sketched. Though in the entire treatment we will use asymptotic Bode plot for representing the system's frequency response, also for stability analysis. But let us see how, what actually the Bode plot is, how it, the information can be obtained and how it can be sketched. So for that, pr- procedure to sketch actual or even you can say exact Bode plot. The softwares like MATLAB, they use this process because in MATLAB you get actual Bode plot and not the asymptotic. But on paper we will draw the asymptotic Bode plot. So let us see the procedure. So for that, let GSHS equal to K into S plus Z1 into S plus Z2 so on up to S plus Zm upon S plus P1 into S plus P2 so on up to S plus Pn with m less than equal to n be the open loop transfer function. Then the frequency response function G of j omega, H of j omega, this is just a repetition of what we have seen in the polar plot, but the latter treatment changes. K into j omega plus z1 into j omega plus z2 so on up to j omega plus zm divided by j omega plus p1 into j omega plus p2 so on up to j omega plus pn. And then its magnitude can be represented as magnitude of g of j omega, h of j omega will be equal to k into magnitude of j omega plus z1 into magnitude of j omega plus z2. So magnitude, that is scalar of every zero, will be in multiplication. Divided by magnitude or scalar of every pole will be in the division. J omega plus P1 into J omega plus P2 so on up to J omega plus Pn. Now this is the magnitude in number. If we want to convert this into dB, then magnitude in dB is, we have to take 20 log of any number that gives us the value in dB. So this is the magnitude. If you want to convert this in dB, it will be 20 log of this. This is log to the base 10, and then we have to take log on this side also. So that will be equal to 20 log k. Now these are in multiplication, so when we take log, it will be in addition. 20 log k plus 20 log magnitude of j omega plus z1 plus 20 log magnitude of j omega plus z2 so on up to 20 log magnitude of j omega plus zm. Now these poles are in the denominator, so they will be subtracted, and hence for this it will be minus 20 log j omega plus p1 minus 20 log magnitude of j omega plus p2 minus so on up to 20 log magnitude j omega plus pn. So this is now the magnitude in dB. Now if we want to find out the phase, so phase of g of j omega, h of j omega, already we have done it in the polar plot. Let us redo it. For k, if it is positive number, there is no phase. Let us start with this. So it is nothing but tan inverse, or instead of tan inverse, let us do it as a phase only, phase of j omega plus z1, because we don't know what is the value of z1, whether it is real or imaginary. So let us keep it in the angle only. So angle of this first 0 plus angle of second 0, so on, of angle of j omega plus zm. So addition of angle of all zeros minus addition of angle of all poles. Now once we find out this magnitude function and phase function, what we can do is, this information is available, so we can plot a table of omega 20 log g of j omega h of j omega, that is magnitude in dB, and angle of g of j omega h of j omega. And for various frequencies, like we cannot start it with 0, but let us say 0.1, 0.2, say 0.5, 1, 2, 5, 10, and so on. Finally, it will be on infinity. And for these values, let us find out this magnitude and phase values to get a table. And then these values will be plotted here. So different magnitude values for different frequencies, they will be plotted, and plot will be joined, and same way the phase. Let us just do it for a representation. It will not be the exact. Let us just do it, and let the phase plot starting here. Let here is the phase plot. So this is the magnitude and phase plot. And as we have seen in the first lecture of frequency response, there it this frequency where it cuts 0 dB line was omega gc. This was our phase gain crossover frequency, the frequency at which it cuts minus 180 phase plot cuts minus 180 degree line is omega pc. Then if we take projection, this will be phase margin. Same way from here, if we take this projection, this will be gain margin. So these are the stability margins from the Bode plot. This is how it can be done. So we have seen what is Bode plot, its applications, its procedure to sketch, and how it can be sketched, and some stability margins on the Bode plot. It is enough in this lecture. In the next lecture, we will see stability analysis using Bode plot. Thank you.